You know, when I was in high school, I started wrestling probably when I was like in seventh grade, and I won states and nationals by the time I was like a junior.
All right, this is it. The moment of truth is here. It's a delight to have you on our show, Riddle. How do you feel about your debut on WWE Now India?
I mean, I feel pretty good. It's you know, I've never done it before. I'm excited. You know, I've always wanted to go to India. Never been, but hopefully, you know, this is just the start. This is just the tip of the iceberg, and I can finally make my way there, you know? So I'm excited. I'm excited to be here.
I'm so excited to have you on our show. I mean, the original bro is in the house. How are you doing on this fine day? We also want to know about your journey in the WWE. Tell us all.
You know, I'm doing marvelous today. It's a beautiful day in Florida, you know. And the journey to WWE wasn't the easiest. You know, I grew up wrestling, amateur, was a state national champion. Started doing jiu-jitsu, won a couple world and national titles at that. After I was done with mixed martial arts, it was time to go into pro wrestling. And I started training about, 6 years ago? And now I'm United States champion in the WWE.
Absolutely. Your journey has been incredible so far. I mean, it hasn't even been the year and you are the United States champion. Absolutely fabulous. How does this make you feel? Such a leap and so fast.
You know, it feels pretty good. But I'm kind of used to like capturing things kind of quick. You know, when I was in high school, I started wrestling probably when I was like in seventh grade. And I won states and nationals by the time I was like a junior. Pro wrestling, even though I got to the main roster and I got a title within a year, it's still from the independent scene to NXT to SmackDown, then to Raw, and then to finally be the United States champion. You know, it was quite a journey. It was, you know, I know it's quick in, you know, some people's eyes, but for me, that was probably the longest journey it ever took to get a championship. So, you know, I'm happy. It was awesome. But probably the hardest thing I've ever had to do was win the United States championship. So pretty juicy about it.
Amazing. You mentioned that it may seem like it was a very quick transition, but I'm sure that there were a lot of changes that you faced along the way, the transition from NXT to Raw. Could you tell us a little more about the challenges that you faced?
You know, yeah. You know, at the end of the day, it's all sports entertainment, it's all wrestling, but there's levels to it. You know, just like there's levels to baseball, levels to football, levels to every sport, or even acting or anything. And with this, the levels on the independent scene is kind of like no rules, do what you want to do, blah, blah, blah. And then NXT, you had TV, you have cameras, you have times, you know, things start to get a little more official and more professional. And then when you get to the main roster, it's a completely different animal. Like, you have to be one of the best in the world just to perform at the main roster level, just because anything can change at any time and you're on live TV, you know? And in WWE, that'll happen, you know?
According to you, which WWE legend would you want to come out of retirement and go on a one-on-one with in the squared circle?
I don't know if I'd want to go one-on-one with him or if I'd want to form a super tag team with him. You know, because it's a, you know, we got a mutual respect for one another, but I think we'd also fight one another too. And he's newly inducted into the Hall of Fame, or will be, and that is Rob Van Dam. If I could get a singles match or a tag match with Rob Van Dam, I would be pretty juicy. You know, I looked up to Rob's, you know, to his career earlier on in my career, and his work rate, the way he talks, the way he does his thing. He didn't care. I don't care. And, you know, he's one of a kind.
That would be an amazing match to watch. Whether you guys go up against each other or form a tag team, either way, you got our money. We're going to watch that match. Your theme, your charisma, your entrance, your flip-flops, they're all so unique. Everything about you screams bro. How did you come up with this one-of-a-kind style?
You know, I get this all the time. I get this question. Where did you come up with the, you know, the bro thing? And I'm like, well, I've said bro like my whole life. I say it a lot. It's just a word. But if you notice in professional wrestling, the fans want something to chant. They want something to say. They want something to do for you, you know? Unlike other sports right. or entertainment, the fans play a huge part in it. And I felt like the word bro was a great way for the fans to get involved. So when I got it involved, I'd sit in promos and stuff, but more so, I'd be in matches, and when I would finish opponents, I would yell bro.
And undoubtedly, it's a very unique, one-of-a-kind thing to scream out too. Bro, we love that. I hope ki the original bro ke saath hamari ye chat aapko achhi lagi ho. Comment section mein hame apne thoughts zarur bataiye. WWE Now India ke is episode mein bas itna hi. I'll see you soon for some more exclusive interviews with your favorite superstars. Main hu aapki host Galen aur main aapse jald milungi.
It's the tikka masala. Yeah.
Right.
Hey, the names, right. the names are a little tricky for the bro. You know, I'm not the best at remembering
things. Got it, bro.